Welcome back to President Trump News Channel. Please subscribe and check notification bell. Thanks for being with us.
Country, it's many countries. We don't talk about it in the news. They don't talk about Mexico and Brazil and still parts of Europe, which actually got hit sooner than us, so it's a little ahead of us in that sense.
Trump pushes back against critics on coronavirus, addresses whether he will accept election results in exclusive interview. The president sat down with Fox News Sunday for a wide-ranging conversation. President Trump, in an exclusive interview with Fox News, challenged his critics on his handling of the coronavirus pandemic, threatened a veto for the defense bill, and speculated on whether he will accept the results if his Democratic challenger wins the presidency in November. Trump, in a contentious sit-down that aired Sunday, told Fox News Sunday host Chris Wallace that recent statistics regarding COVID-19 cases and deaths are misleading. Early in the discussion, the president disputed Wallace's claim that the U.S. currently has the seventh highest mortality rate in the world. President Trump pays tribute to John Lewis, a civil rights hero. "I think we have one of the lowest mortality rates in the world," Trump said, offering White House statistics that differed from the ones Wallace cited. Wallace then explained that his numbers came from Johns Hopkins University, which ranked the U.S. seventh in mortality, ahead of the U.K., and worse than Brazil and Russia. He noted that the White House's chart, which uses data from the European Center for Disease Protection and Control, has the U.S. ahead of Spain and Italy, but worse than Brazil and South Korea, with Russia and other countries not included in the chart. From there, Trump pushed back against statements from leading U.S. doctors, specifically CDC Director Robert Redfield and National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases Director Anthony Fauci. Redfield said last week that he expects the coming fall and winter to be among the most difficult times that we've experienced in American public health. When asked if he agrees with Redfield, Trump said he was unsure, but pointed to mistakes that doctors have made. "I don't know and I don't think he knows," Trump said. "I don't think anybody knows with this. This is a very tricky deal. Everybody thought this summer it would go away and it would come back in the fall. Well, when the summer came, they used to say the heat was good for it, and it really knocks it out, remember? And then it might come back in the fall. So they got that one wrong." Trump then addressed perceived tension between him and Fauci, who was targeted by Trump aide Daniel Scavino, who tweeted a cartoon depicting Fauci as a leaker and an alarmist. When asked about this, Trump appeared to partially agree with it. "Well, I don't know that he's a leaker," Trump said before adding, "he's a little bit of an alarmist." "That's okay. A little bit of an alarmist." The president insisted that he and Fauci have a great relationship, but claimed that he was wrong early in the pandemic by saying it would pass, and that Trump's ban on travel from China was a mistake. "He then admitted that I was right," Trump said. When confronted with the notion that he, too, has made errors, Trump did not push back. "I guess everybody makes mistakes," the president said, then added, "I'll be right eventually. I will be right eventually," referring to his past prediction that the virus would eventually go away. "It's going to disappear and I'll be right," he said. In the meantime, Trump says that he takes responsibility for what happens to the nation during the pandemic, as critics claim that the U.S. does not have a national plan. Anthony Fauci praises New York's coronavirus response. "They did it correctly. Look, I take responsibility always for everything because it's ultimately my job, too. I have to get everybody in line," Trump said, while stating that governors have to lead as well. "Some governors have done well, some governors have done poorly," he said. Trump downplayed the recent rise in national case numbers, claiming that it is the result of increased testing, with the implication that it is not a true rise in the severity of the pandemic, a claim that leading health experts have disputed. Trump pointed to new cases that include people with minor symptoms who recover quickly. Early on during the pandemic, it was mainly those with serious symptoms were getting tested. "No country has ever done what we've done in terms of testing. We are the envy of the world," he said. The Trump administration announced that they are supporting a lawsuit to overturn Obamacare. When asked why he would oppose something that people are relying on during a pandemic, Trump said he will be replacing it soon and is signing a healthcare plan within 2 weeks.
Are twice as likely, fewer in absolute numbers, but in terms of per capita, blacks are